G'day everyone, welcome to another episode of Python for Mindstorms. Today we're going to learn how to use functions. Hello, my name is Gary. If anything in this lesson doesn't make sense, make sure you check out the previous video over here. All our lessons are building on top of each other, so we are assuming that you have watched the previous lesson so that we don't have to cover off some of the older details. Functions, they're really, really helpful. Functions are used in all sorts of areas of programming, so make sure that you can repeat certain bits of your code so that you don't have to retype things over and over again. And it's a really important part of becoming a programmer. In Scratch, functions come in the form of something called myblocks. So if you're used to using myblocks in Scratch, then this is going to be really familiar to you, okay? So let's dive straight into it and try to make tricky do really accurate turns, okay? So let's jump in. Start a new project. Create a new project, Python. And we are going to save this as CA Python functions. All right, so on top of our default code, let's set our movement motors. Let's change it up a bit. Let's call our movement motors wheels this time, because remember, these objects can be named whatever you want, so just call it wheels. Wheels equals motor pair A, B. All right, so we're going to try and make our robot do a really accurate turn. So if we have a look at our robot, unlike in EV3 or like we do too, or any of the other robots, Spike Prime has an inbuilt gyro. So the gyro inside the hub is called a motion sensor in the Python classes. So the motion sensor has an inbuilt gyro, and what we want to do is make the robot turn until the gyro senses that we're past a certain angle. So before we go into the functions, let's do a very basic 90 degree turn. Okay, so let's do a 90 degree turn. And to do a 90 degree turn, some people will get confused. Some people go, oh, well, let's go wheels dot move, and then say, oh, I'm gonna go 90 degrees. So 90 degrees or something like that. But that's not right, because the degrees that you have in the move function is simply the rotation of the wheel. So it's moving the wheel like 90 degrees. It's not actually moving the robot 90 degrees. In order to do that, we need to actually use the function on the motion sensor. So the correct way to do it is while hub.motionSensor. This is how we access all the motion sensor methods. Dot get your angle is less than 90 degrees. So this is a while loop where we're repeating the right hand turn motion until we hit 90 degrees. So while it is less than 90, then our wheels dot start 100. So remember, start 100, the 100 is representing the steer value. 100 is this complete turn towards the right, and negative 100 is turning towards the left. It defaults to 0, which is a straight move. Okay, and also we want to go wheels dot set default speed. Set default speed 20, just so that's nice and easy. Let's connect our robot up. Thank you. connected. Now let's run the code, see if we do a 90 degree turn. Nope. What's wrong here? Ah, the reason it's not stopping is because we haven't told it to stop. Because we're still starting the motion at 100, but we didn't tell it what to do when it exits the loop. So here we go like this. When it exits the loop, we go wheels.stop. And now that should be right. Beautiful. Okay, now imagine I want to create this as a my block in Scratch, right? If I wanted to create a my block, then I would copy all the blocks and then define a new block called right hand turn. Okay, so that's exactly the same as what we're going to do now. So we're going to create a function that is a right hand turn function and copy all this code into it so that every time we want to make a right hand turn, we just run the function. So how do we do that? Here we're going to define our right-hand turn function. So when we're defining functions, we want to do them in between where we've created the objects and where we're running our program. So define functions. So, and the define functions keyword is def, D-E-F, or define. We're going to call it right turn. Okay. Define right turn, open and close brackets, colon. So this is how you define everything inside this function. Everything that's indented under this right turn function is going to be part of the function. So here we're going to copy all this, except for the speed, cut it out, and paste it in here, and make sure that we are indenting the correct amount. So the while loop starts indented, and then the wheel starting is indented further, and then the wheel stop is outdented. Okay, so the indentation in Python is really important because it represents what is inside the scope of each function. So after we have defined the function, we need to call the function. So over here, we call the function by saying right turn. Okay. So we define the functions here, and then we call the function afterwards. Every time we say right turn, open and close bracket, it's going to make it do a right turn. Okay. Let's check it out. Okay, so if I ran it twice, then I can go right turn, then do another right turn. Ah, it didn't do the second right turn, and why is that? It's because the gyro only reset itself at the start of the function. So in order to do a second right turn, we need to reset the gyro yaw angle before we run the right hand turn. So in order to do that, it's a good thing that we have a function now, right? Because now our function is going to make this really helpful. When we do the right turn, before we run the right turn, we're going to go and say hub.motionSensor.ResetYawAngle. Okay, that way, whenever you call the right turn function, it immediately resets the angle to zero before it starts to do the turn. Okay, let's try that now. Okay, all right. But now, how do we add parameters in there? What if we don't want to do a right-hand turn all the time? What if I want to make a turn to a custom angle? That's where we add parameters in. Just like in Scratch, when you create a my block, you can add a parameter, like an input in there. In Python, it's exactly the same. We add a parameter to the function. So let's create a custom function where we define what the angle it is that we are turning when we're turning towards the right. Okay, let's have a look. So this is the right turn function, but we are going to create a new one. We're going to create a new one called define custom turn. And then we're going to put in the angle, angle. All right. And then we say everything is the same except for the 90 degrees. Okay. So hub motion sensor, reset your angle. That's exactly the same. But now instead of getting the yaw angle to be less than 90, it's going to be less than whatever our angle is, right? And then we can keep on turning. So now we can do a 45 degree turn by saying custom turn 45. Okay, so let's try that. See? That's it from us today. I hope you enjoyed the lesson, functions and turning angles with gyro. Very important lesson this time, and a nice and short one too. So next time we're going to continue with our Python challenges. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.